I'm Jennifer McCray, and I work here at Erikson Institute. I'm the director of our Early Mathematics Education Project. So I'm here to talk to you about math. Everyone's favorite subject, right? What we've figured out, we provide professional development to teachers. So that means teachers who are actively teaching preschool and kindergarten come to Erikson, and we have workshops with them where we talk about early mathematics, okay? And what we've figured out is that there are a lot of sort of misunderstandings out there about early math, what it is, what it looks like, and what it means to teach it. So I'm structuring my talk by pointing out some of these misunderstandings and trying to talk with you about why we think they are misunderstandings and get us all sort of on the same page. And so myth number one. For young children, learning mathematics is less important than developing early literacy and language skills. Now, some of us would probably say, yeah, maybe so. You know, I mean, if I had to pick one, I'd probably pick early literacy, right? You know, reading is so critical to any future learning, okay? So that makes sense. I understand why sometimes people think this is the case. And in fact, the evidence is clear that that's the way we kind of operate. This is based on some recent work done here at Erikson and with some other team members. And we found that if you went into 100 early childhood classrooms on any given day, you'd only see mathematics activity occurring in 21 of them, whereas there'd be 96 where you'd see language arts or literature. Art and music is somewhere around 30, okay? So clearly we're operating on this principle, right? Gotta get that literacy in, which is great. Literacy is very important, okay? But we also have some interesting findings from a recent study. This was done at Northwestern University, published in 2007. And it's longitudinal data. What that means is that we were able to follow children. So we have scores when they're 5, we have scores when they're 8, and we have scores when they're 13, okay? And we found that your early reading skills do in fact predict your later reading achievement. That makes sense. Right? So how you're reading in kindergarten tells us how you're likely to be reading when you get older. Okay? We also found that that was true for math skills. Your early math skills do predict your later math achievement. Not a big surprise. But we also found that early math skills predict later reading achievement. And the same cannot be said for early reading scores. Okay? For whatever reason, the early math scores have a much stronger predictive power. So where children are in mathematics at the kindergarten year predicts both math and reading at a later time. But the early literacy isn't providing the same kind of prediction, okay? It's not as related to what happens later. So whenever we present this data, people say, well, why? What's that about? You know, help me understand it. Good question. In order to do that, I want to show you a game that we sometimes have our teachers do with the kids that they're teaching. We have them set up what we call a number station, and we say, make that number. And the number station that we're going to make today is based on the number 6. So I would have a table here, and it would have maybe a big card on it. It might have the numeral 6, and then maybe it would have 6 dots to help remind kids what 6 looks like, okay? And then I would put out a big bin of, these are called Unifix cubes. And we say to the teachers, put out only 2 colors, okay? So you take out all the brown and the green and the yellow, and I'm just leaving the red and the blue, okay? You say to children, how many ways can you make 6? You give them a tray and let them go at it. So, of course, one way to make 6, if you have red and blue Unifix cubes, is 3 and 3, right? But you can also make 6 with 2 and 4, right? Okay, see, these are 6. You can also make 6 with 1 and 5. So here's my 5. And my 1. And then there's 6 and 0. That's right. Okay, so there are a lot of different combinations, different ways for kids to make the 6. Okay? So this doesn't even have 0 in it as an example. And if you go up to 3 colors, right, you put some yellow in there, then suddenly, you know, you exponentially increase the number of different possible combinations. Well, the point of the activity is to help kids begin to see the cardinality of number and the idea that numbers represent quantity. And one of the things that comes with that idea is this idea that a number can be, a 6 can be broken apart into 2 other numbers, okay? And that 2 numbers, 2 sets, can be combined to create a set of a different amount. It's an idea that is so basic that as adults, we take it for granted. I mean, it's an obvious, it's a no-brainer, right? But children have to learn it. They have to experience it. And so this is an activity that we would do to help them with that. And the reason I'm spending some time showing it to you is that I think it demonstrates how many different kinds of thinking are going on when children do this activity. They've got to be able to think flexibly. They have to be able to see that there are other possibilities besides the 3 and 3, okay? They've got to be analytical, so that once they've created a couple of these, they can think to themselves, what's another way? You know, they might do it, I did it systematically, didn't I? I started with 3 and 3, and then I went 2 and 4, and 1 and 5. A little kid might start by jumping around, right? All of one color, 3 and 3, 1 and 5, you know, and then if they're trying to get to all of the different ways to make it, then they might have to get more analytical. They might have to get more systematic to see what are the remaining possibilities and to make sure that they actually do hit them all. There's a lot of abstraction in this and a lot of problem solving going on, okay? So the kinds of thinking that go on when children are engaged in early mathematics activities apply much more broadly than do some of the skills that come up in literacy. They don't apply to mathematics in the same way. But math has built into it this emphasis on logical thought, on abstract thinking, on systematic thinking that has a lot of application when children are doing literacy. So that's how we explain that finding about early math scores predicting later reading scores.